All right, guys, we are moving along on CLT math practice number 2, question number 96. It says a point 4, negative 3 is reflected across the x-axis. If this new point is on a line with the point 2, 1, then what is the equation of that line? Well, for me, my first step will be to graph that point real fast. 4, negative 3. My 4 is telling me to start at the origin and go right by 4 on the x-axis and go down by 3 on the y-axis. And now this point is reflected across the y-axis. So we're taking our coordinate plane and we're folding it over. So this point moves from down here to an equal distance up here. So that's up 1, 2, 3. And continuing with the question, I'm going to erase my original point and only look at the point after it moved. If this new point is on a line with the point 2, 1, so right by 2, up by 1, then what is the equation of that line? I can see right here between these two points. I'm going down 2, back 2, down 2, back 2. Look at that. I've got me a y-intercept, and I've also got the slope. So if my y-intercept, it's touching the y-axis at negative 1, and my slope, I'm going up 2 over 2, right? Because when I was looking at it originally, I looked from my first point to my second point, I said down 2, back 2, and now I'm saying up 2 over 2, because when I'm writing out my slope officially, right, we always look from left to right. So this is a positive slope because looking from left to right, the line is increasing. So 2 divided by 2 is 1. My slope is 1. So y equals mx plus b. I can use my slope intercept formula and plug in a 1 for my slope and plug in a negative 1 for my y-intercept, and I can see that the answer is C. That looks like a nice, fair question, similar to what we've done in an Algebra 1 class. Moving forward to question number 97. If 2x equals 5 over y, then which of the following is equivalent to the expression 2x squared? So in order for me to find this, what I want to do is I want to get this x right here only by itself. So 2x equals 5 over y. How do I get rid of 2 and with this x? I want to get the x by itself, right? The 2 and the x are doing what together? Sitting together, they're multiplying. How do we get rid of something that's multiplying? You would divide both sides by 2, divided by 2, to make these cancel out. So I can cancel those. And now I have like a fraction over a fraction, and this always makes me go back to fifth grade teacher mode for a fraction divided by a whole number. It makes me want to do keep, change, flip. So I'm going to rewrite this as keep the top, 5 over y, change division, change the fraction to times to multiply, and flip my 2 into 1 over 2. So really we're multiplying by the reciprocal to give us that x equals 5, because 5 times 1 is 5, over 2y. And now we want to find out what is 2x squared equals to 2. And I'm going to sub this in for x, because look at all of the answer choices here, right? They got rid of the x. 5 over 2y squared. And now my order of operations says I have to take care of my exponents before I can multiply that 2. So when I raise this fraction to the power of 2, I'm going to raise the top to the power of 2, the numerator squared, and the denominator squared. So that's 2 times my numerator squared, 5 squared, it's 5 times 5, 25, over my denominator squared, 2 squared is 4, and y squared. Now I can multiply this by 2. I'm going to take my 2 and just make it a fraction, 2 over 1 times 25 over 4y squared. Now I can look at my answer choices and say, not it. Hold on a second. Let me finish simplifying. Trying to skip steps might be messing myself up. 2 times 25 is 50 over 1 times 4y squared. 4y squared. The only one with a 50 does not have a 4y squared. So we got to simplify our fraction. Since 50 and 4 are both even numbers, then I can just write an equivalent fraction by dividing the numerator and the denominator by the same number. Since they're even, I can divide them both by 2. And I know that 50 divided by 2 takes me back to 25, and 4 divided by 2 gives me 2y squared. And oops, I almost counted you out, B, but you are the correct answer. So looking back, instead of taking these extra couple of steps, I should have simplified right here and canceled out this 2 and this 4. But that's okay. We found the right answer. The more of these you do, the faster you get. Same goes for the teacher, right? Okay. Number 98. A circle in the xy coordinate plane is given by the equation x minus 5 squared plus y squared equals 49. What is the area of the circle in square units? To be honest, I have not been doing a lot of problems with circle equations, and they do not give you the formula for a circle equation on the reference sheet for this test. So you've got to have this in your back pocket. This is an equation that you want to know. A circle equation, right, is going to give you your x minus an x coordinate squared plus your y minus a y coordinate squared equals to the radius squared. And it says, okay, a circle in the xy coordinate plane is given by the equation x minus 5 squared plus y squared equals 49. What is the area of the circle in square units? Area of the circle. In order to find the area of a circle equals, this is on the reference sheet, this piece is, pi r squared. Well, that's also in the equation for your circle equation, r squared. R squared is 49. So it's just 49 pi. And when you're looking at this formula also, these x and y coordinates are your coordinates for the center of your circle. So that might, jog your memory and help you with another question, maybe on the test somewhere else. Let's see. I've got time for number 99 on this video. It says, a regular hexagon has one side that measures 6 inches. What is the area of the hexagon? A hexagon is a figure with how many sides? 6 sides. And being that it's a regular hexagon, those 6 sides are all going to be equivalent. They're going to be equal. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Mine does not look exactly equivalent. We'll just say that Mrs. Cameron's hexagon is made out of Jell-O. And I did the best I could, okay? All right, so there's a regular-ish hexagon. So when I look at this, right, you see I made these lines in the middle because I can look at my hexagon as if it's made out of 6 equilateral triangles. I don't have a formula memorized for the area of a hexagon, but I do know my formula for the area of a triangle. So I've got area of one triangle is 1/2 of base times height. And I know that a side length of my hexagon is 6. And I know these are all going to be equilateral triangles. So let me pull out one of these triangles here like this. This equilateral triangle like this, okay? And I'm now going to cut my triangle in half. Like this. To give myself a height and to give myself a right angle-ish, okay? Best I could do. It's supposed to be a corner angle, a 90-degree angle. I want that so that I can find out my height here. Oh, no. Oops. It looks like I am running out of time on my video. So I would like for you to see if you can figure out what to do with these first hints. And on the next video, I'll finish up question number 99.